Sir, as my colleague, honourable colleague, has pointed out, we are supporting this bill because of the compulsion. Sir, the 92nd Department-related Standing Committee in 2016 have made certain recommendations and also highlighted the problems that are being faced, that were being faced on various issues with the Medical Council of India and the necessity to solve these burning problems, including the transparency and the reforms to be brought in and the rampant corruption that was prevailing since Amendment 1993. My submission is, if you go back to the original Act 1956, and there was a true federal structure, and subsequently the amendment in 1993, the provisions relating to maintaining the federal structure have been amended, and some sort of autocracy and then centralization of power has come with the introduction of 1993 amendment bill, sir. Sir, my suggestion in this regard, my humble suggestion is, I request the government of India, particularly the Minister of Health, who is sitting, I request you to kindly listen to me, sir. The council, medical council, should be on the similar lines to that of the GST. Then only the federal structure can be maintained. Sir, from every state, there are 29 states in this country. From every state, there has to be a representative. In the case of GST, the finance minister of the respective state is the member of the GST council here. In the similar manner, either the minister of the health minister of the state or state representative should be the member of the Medical Council of India. Then only the federal structure can be maintained, sir. Sir, since MCI is being replaced with a parallel body like Board of Directors for a period of 2 years, I hope the health minister will not come back again in 2021 and say that the very objective with which this board of director is board of the parallel body is constituted is not fulfilled. Therefore, I hope he will not ask for extension of time, sir. Sir, I would like to ask one more question: whether the policy has been formulated by the government of India for this period of 2 years, so that the problems what we have faced and the lack of performance and the corruption that has taken place earlier will not be repeated and recurred, sir. And another question is, has the government designed any plan of action for the next 2 years or not? Has the government identified the weaknesses and challenges and proposed the measures to overcome them or not? Simply forming the new board is not sufficient. It is also very important to ensure that the new parallel body will deliver its objectives, so that the board of directors and reconstituted medical council should be allowed to run the body with the eminent doctors, not with the persons who are corrupt and who have corrupted the system. Sir, then over centralization of power, sir. One more point. One of the major reasons for failure of Medical Council of India was too much of power being centralized in the single body. Again, you are denying an opportunity to me, sir. It is important to ensure that the council is well managed and divided into different departments. And it is not what the people of India expect, that centralization of power, as is pointed out with the Secretary General or General Secretary or whoever it is. Sir, in this country, with a population of more than 130 crores, the government expenditure on health is a meager of 1.8% of GDP, and when compared to the other countries, it has to be increased to 2.5% of GDP, sir. And finally, sir, few more points. Give me one more minute. Sir, I would like to bring to the notice of the August House the sorry state of affairs in so far as health sector is concerned, sir. Sir, as a layman, as a normal citizen of this country, we always feel the doctor profession is a noble profession, but that proverb is no longer holds good, sir. Sir, the the corruption in the
Yes, Reddy, conclude. I'll move to the other speaker now.
Yes, yes.
Already 6 minutes you have taken instead of four.
Give me one more.
No, sir. No, I'm moving.
Public health care, sir. One more minute, sir.
No, not one more minute. I'm moving to the next speaker.
Sir, what? Half a minute, sir. Private hospitals, particularly private hospitals, are resorting to very, very corrupt and unwarranted practices, sir. And they are forcing the patients to go for unwarranted medical checkups, which are not really required, so that they can charge exorbitant
fees. Thank you, V.Viyajsai Reddy ji.
Including the laboratories.
Manek Sir Kanak
Medlar Arvind Kumar. These problems are to be addressed by the government.